our story. We will introduce the title of the story, everything about the story, characters, and of course the events that will happen in this story. First of all, in this lesson we will introduce Literature Study Sheet 3. Again, Literature Study Sheet 3. So this is the third story that will be with you. We will discuss everything that related to this story. So let's start with our story. We are on Unit 8, Literature Book, page 170, and the story title is God Sees the Truth But Waits, Part 1. So I will ask you to open your Literature Book, page 170. This is Unit 8, the last story that we will have. And the title is God Sees the Truth But Waits, and of course it is Part 1. Now, before we will start talking about the story or Part 1 of the story or the first page of Part 1, we will introduce something about the most important elements of the story, the thing that we do before reading the story and before introducing the whole story. So as you see, Literature Study Sheet 3, title of the story is God Sees the Truth But Waits. Now from the title, you can expect that we are going to read something about events that related maybe to some values, something related to the characters, what would happen to them. Now think about the title. What are your expectations about the title? What are we going to read about from the title? As I ask you always before we start reading the story, God sees the truth, that God or Allah can see the truth, but waits for the people to maybe stop doing the thing that may be the wrong thing that they are doing. God gives them opportunities or chances in order to change themselves. Now, this is the thing that we will discuss and see. Maybe we have more than the thing that we are going to talk about. So first of all, getting ready to read, learning about literature. Here we are focusing on the element. Each and every story, we have something to focus on, something that is talking about the whole story. If you remember, previously we talked about the character, the main person or the main person in the story. We talked about many elements. If you remember, we talked about folk tales. So today we are going to talk about the mood. So number one, what is the mood of a story? What is the mood of a story? The word mood, what do you mean by mood? Now maybe you know the word before. Mood, it means maybe how do you feel, what are you doing today, what is happening to you, okay? So, the mood is, follow with me, the feeling or atmosphere that the writer creates. For example, if the story is funny and amusing, the mood will be humorous. If a story contains many happy events, the mood will be joyous. So, the mood is the feeling. How do you feel? From inside, of course. Or atmosphere, the environment, the thing around you, that surrounded you, that the writer creates. Who made this atmosphere or feeling? The writer. Of course, to whom? To the reader, yes. For example, if the story is funny, if the story has maybe funny events and amusing, that you feel that you are amazed by the events, the mood will be humorous. So the mood will be funny. We have fun. We have something to laugh at. If a story contains many happy events, if we have a story that has happy events, events that made you happy, the mood will be joyous. Joyous, it means happy. That you can feel that you are full of happiness, of joy. Joy means happiness. So, the mood is the feeling or the atmosphere. It depends on the story or the events of the story. If the events of the story are funny, so the mood is funny or the mood is humorous. It means that you can laugh. You are enjoying your time. If the story has contains happy events, of course, we have joyous atmosphere. Number two, what is the mood of the story of God sees the truth but waits? So here we are asking about the mood of our story. So in question number one, we talked about the mood in general. Now, in our story, which is titled by God Sees the Truth But Waits, what is the mood of this story? Is it, for example, humorous? Is it sad? Is it joyous? Now, the answer. The story is filled with important events. So the events that we will talk about in this story, the events are important and very thoughtful, that it make you, or it makes you to think, or it drives you to think more. So the mood is serious. So what is the mood of our story? The mood is serious. It means it's not something to laugh at. It's not something that you feel that you maybe, now maybe you can feel that you are happy in some events, but here in our story, it has important events. Because of that, the mood is serious. Now, you will have to memorize these two questions about what do we mean by the mood, and what is the mood of this story. The mood, it means الجو العام للقصة. It means the atmosphere, feeling. So here, for God Sees the Truth, it is serious. And now, my students, now here we are on part one, as you can see, and we are on page 170. So follow up with me in your literature book. Open page 170. Now you will listen to this page. Here I have the first half of this page from Leo Tolstoy until the word home, as you can see, about maybe the first and the second paragraphs. Now you will listen and we will start explaining this page. So follow up with me, please.
Turn to page 170. Listen to God Sees the Truth But Waits by Leo Tolstoy. Part 1. Leo Tolstoy, the great Russian writer, was interested in the meaning of life. This story is a good example of his writing.
In the town of Vladimir in Russia, there lived a wealthy young merchant named Ivan Aksenov. He owned two shops and a large house. Aksenov was a handsome, blonde, curly-haired fellow who loved to have fun and was very fond of singing. Years ago, when he was much younger, he sometimes drank too much and got into trouble. But after he got married, he gave up drinking. One summer afternoon, Aksenov was preparing to go to the fair at Nizhny, where he hoped to sell his merchandise. As he was saying goodbye to his family, his wife said to him, "Ivan, please do not go to the fair today. I dreamed that something bad happened to you there. For my sake, please stay at home."
So, as you listen to this page, we'll start with page 170. Now, the first two lines, as you can see, we are introducing the writer of the story. His name is Leo Tolstoy. Leo Tolstoy. He is a great Russian writer. Now, the word, the words in red color, these are the words that you should memorize them. Now, some of them, some of these words have English meaning, others only Arabic meaning. And I will write them to you in Literature Study 3, the sheet that, or the study sheet that I will give it to you in the weekly plan for the next week, inshallah. Now, the great Russian writer. Now, Russian, it means that he came from Russia, and he was interested in the meaning of life. He was so much interested in the meaning of life. What do you mean by life? Why are we living in this life? What is the point or the goal behind being humans in this life? This story is a good example of his writing. So, the story is titled by God Sees the Truth But Waits. For whom? What is the name of the writer? Yes, he is Leo Tolstoy. And where did he come from? He came from Russia, because he is a great Russian writer. He is a great Russian writer. Now, the first paragraph, as you can see, from the word in the town of Vladimir until drinking. Here we are introducing the main character of the story. The main character, it means the main person in the character, in the story, which means the most important person in the story. His name is Ivan Aksinov, okay? And we'll start with talking about in the town of Vladimir in Russia, there lived a wealthy young merchant. Here, I will ask you a question. Where did he live, or where did Aksinov live? Your answer should be that he lived in the town of Vladimir in Russia. In the town of Vladimir, the name of the town is Vladimir. In which country? In Russia. He was a wealthy young merchant. So what was his job? What was his job? Was he a teacher? Was he a pilot? Was he a farmer? No, he was a wealthy young merchant. Merchant, it means the person who sells goods, sells products, okay? Named Ivan Aksinov. He owned two shops and a large house. So he had shops, two shops, and a large house. Now, the second part, Aksinov was a handsome, blonde, curly-haired fellow. Now, here we are talking about what? His appearance. How did he lie? How did he look like? What was his, the characteristics of him, or things that you can describe him, the description of him. Yes, he was handsome. It means that he was beautiful, nice, blonde, that he has blonde hair, or his skin is blonde, and he had curly-haired man. It means that he had curly hair. Philo here, it means a man, okay, who loved to have fun and was very fond of singing. He was too much interested in singing. He liked to sing a lot. Years ago, when he was much younger, he sometimes drank too much. So here we have something bad about him, that before he got married, he used to do something wrong. But now when he got married, he gave up. بمعنى, he stopped everything bad. Now, the second paragraph is talking about that in one summer afternoon, in one day, he decided to go to the fair. The word fair here in red, fair, it means to a place where you can sell your product or your goods. He's a merchant, okay? He's a merchant, it means tajir. So he sells and maybe can buy something and sell it to people. So he decided to go to the fair at Nijni. Nijni is a place that he will go to sell his merchandise, the word that you can see in front of you in red color. Merchandise, it means the things that he's going to sell, goods maybe, bada'i' or anything that he wants to sell. And here we are talking about something about his family, that he had a family and he came to say goodbye to his family because he will go in order to sell his merchandise. So here, in this paragraph, if I ask you, why do you think that Aksinov was preparing himself to go to the fair? Your answer should be that he was preparing to go to the fair at Nijni, where he hoped to sell his merchandise. So to sell his merchandise. So he said what? He said to his wife that I will go to the fair, but she refused to let him to go to the fair. Why is that? The last two lines, as you can see, she said, Ivan, please do not go to the fair. I dream that something bad happened to you there. For my sake, please stay at home. So why do you think that his wife refused him to go to the fair, or she didn't like his way, or she didn't like his decision to go to the fair? She said, no, please don't go. Why is that? Yes, if you look at the paragraph, you should say that because she had a bad dream, that she dreamed of something bad that will happen to whom? To Ivan Aksinov, her husband. Okay? Now, we will move to the second 70. So listen carefully.
Aksinov laughed and said, You know that I have got to go to the fair. What are you afraid of? His wife replied, I do not know what I am afraid of. All I know is that I had a bad dream. I dreamed that you were coming home from the fair, and when you took off your cap, I saw that your hair had turned gray. Aksenov laughed and said, That means good luck. You'll see. I'll sell everything I bring to the fair, and I'll come home with some wonderful presents for you all. Then Ivan kissed his wife and children, said goodbye, and departed. When he had traveled halfway to Nizhny, he met a merchant he knew, and they stopped at an inn for the night. They discussed business.
So, the second part of 170, here we have Aksenov laughed and said, we continued. Now, his wife told him not to go to the fair. Please don't go because I have bad dream that something bad will happen to you. What was Aksenov's reaction? Did he agree? Did he stay home or he went to the fair? He said, you know that I have got to go to the fair. What are you afraid of? He told her that I have to go because I have to sell goods so I can bring money to feed maybe the family or the children. So here, the following three lines, his wife replied that I don't know what I am afraid of. She insisted to tell him that I don't know what I'm afraid of, but I am sure that I had a bad dream, and I'm sure that there is something bad that will happen to you. In these lines also, we talked about her dream. What was Aksenov's wife's dream? What was her dream? She said in the second line, as you see, I dreamed that you were coming home from the fair, and when you took off your cap, I saw that your hair had turned gray. She told him that I dreamed that you went to the fair. When you came back to the home, you took off your cap. Your cap, it means your hat on his head. And your hair turned to gray, to the color of gray, which is the mix between maybe black and white. Okay. So what was Aksenov's reaction? Did he, or was he convinced of her a dream? He said no. He laughed and he said that's a good luck. And by that, I will sell everything and I will come home with wonderful presents. Present, it means that I will bring to you gift, something good for you and for my children. In the last three lines, then Ivan kissed his wife and children. So he said goodbye and he departed, which means he left where? He was going to the fair. At which place? Nizhny. Okay? Now, while he was traveling, in his way, he met another merchant. He met whom? Another merchant, another man, okay? He knew, of course, and they stopped at an inn, the word inn, as you can see in red. Inn, it means a place where it's like hotel or a place where you can sleep and be in this place when you are away of your home. For the night, and they discussed, so they start to have discussion, of course, about maybe business or another thing. We will see on the next page, 171. So by the end of this page, you should know who are the characters. We can say Ivan Aksenov, his wife, his children, and the other merchant. You should know also the meaning of these words in red. You have Arabic. Some of them have English meanings. And I will send them to you with the new weekly plan, inshallah. Now, for this page, these questions, we have about six questions that you have to read them, understand them, and memorize them as usual. You should memorize the answer correctly. So here we have the questions, part 1, page 170. I will read them to you. They are very easy. Only for 170. Number 1, where did Aksenov live? We introduced it at the beginning of the page. He lived in the town of Vladimir in Russia. In the town of Vladimir in Russia. Number 2, what was his job? He was a wealthy young merchant. Yes, he was a wealthy young merchant. He wasn't poor. He was wealthy young merchant. Number 3, how did Aksenov look like? Tell me about his description. Was he young? Was he old? Was he a blonde? What? Now, he was a handsome, a blonde, curly-haired man. Handsome, a blonde, curly-haired man. Number four. Where did Aksinov plan to go and why? You should answer without looking at the question. He planned or he was preparing the answer to go to the fair where he hoped to sell his merchandise. Again, he was preparing to go to the fair. What do you mean by fair? It's a place where you can sell your goods. Here, a souk. And he hoped to sell some of his merchandise, which means bada'i' or the things that he will sell. Five, why did his wife not want him to go to the fair? Why do you think that she said, no, please don't go? Yes, if you understood the page, you should say that she dreamed that something bad had happened to him there. Because she had a dream that there is something bad happened to Aksinov. Number six, what did Aksinov's wife dream? What was her dream? She dreamed that Aksinov was coming back home from the fair, and when he took off his cap, his hair had turned gray. So, his hair had turned gray. The thing that when he took off his hat, his hair turned gray. And by this page, we finished page 170 from part 1. And here you have, or you should memorize the questions that you have in front of you.